Hello friends, welcome back one more time on my YouTube channel. You might have heard that some children have swallowed something in their mouth, maybe the coin, maybe the magnet, maybe the battery. So many things they put in their mouth and they swallow it while they are playing. Just few days, I have one child who came in my emergency room who has swallowed the coin and the parents were in panic situation. And that's why I have decided that let me make one video on that one so that you will be get acknowledged that what are the things you can do at home and how to reach to the emergency and how fast to reach to the emergency so that it will be good for the child. Welcome back. I am Dr. Nilesh Panchal, specialist pediatrician. I hope this video must be useful to you. Friends, children put a lot of things in their mouth while they are playing. Many times metal balls, magnets, batteries of the toys, sometimes the safety pin, hair bands, pencil erasers, so many things they put in their mouth and they swallow it. Once they swallow it, it is a really troublesome situation and it is a panic situation for the parents as well as the doctors. And many times some children require some treatment and most of the children doesn't require the treatment. So how we will go about it? Let me discuss those things in this video. First of all, which are the common age group which swallow those objects so that you should be very careful for this age group. Generally, after 7 or 8 months, once the child will become little mobile, they will pick up the things in their hand. And as they don't have a good knowledge about it, they try to test it. They try to put the things in the mouth and accidentally they swallow it. Generally, less than 5-year children are very common who swallows these objects. Commonest things which we are seeing in our emergency room or in our pediatric OPD also are the coins. The coins are the most common things that children put in their mouth. Many times parents are also responsible for that because they give the coins to play to the child. If you are aware that I have prepared one video about the how to buy the toys. In that video I have specifically mentioned that toys which you buy should be larger than the baby's mouth so that child cannot swallow it. So the toys which you buy should be bigger enough so that child should not put in the mouth and he should not swallow. You should not give the coins to the children to play because most of the time the children put the coins in the mouth and they will play and they will accidentally swallow it. How to know this one that whether child has swallowed any foreign object like the coin or the magnet? Most of the time, if the child is bigger, like around 2.5 or 3 years of the age, they will come and show the signs that he has taken something. But the smaller children, they don't tell you. So that what are the symptoms? Symptoms are like excessive drooling from the mouth. They will find difficulty in the swallowing, vomiting, and sometimes there is an abdominal distension if it is lasted for a longer time, and sometimes child not pass the stool. Those are the things which are common symptoms of the obstructed intestine. What are the signs of the intestinal obstruction? That means the intestines are not moving so well so that it has twisted inside or it is blocked inside. First of all, it is a green color vomiting, severe abdominal pain, abdominal distension which is huge, and child may not pass the stool. Those are the some of the signs of the intestinal obstruction. Those are very important to know because those are the serious sign where the child might require the surgeries. So suppose if you have noticed or child has told you that child has ate some foreign object like the battery or the magnet, what you will do at home? Most of the objects which child are taking in their mouth, if they went into the intestinal tract, like if there is a esophagus, food pipe, then there is a stomach, then there is an intestine. So the objects which pass through the esophagus, they are going to get stored into the stomach. Then as with the food, it will pass into the stomach and then it will come out through the anus or through the stool or maybe the potty. So most of the object which child ate or swallowed, generally they are not very harmful. But if the objects goes and lodge into the respiratory tract, which is a windpipe, then it can cause a problem. Then it is an emergency. You have to rush to the hospital. Most of the dry fruits, if you have started in a seed form in the younger age group, then while they are eating, it will go into the windpipe. that causes the emergency. You have to rush to the hospital immediately. Now the objects which pass through the intestinal tract doesn't cause much problem. Let's take the example of the coin. Suppose any child who has ingested the coin. First and foremost thing what you have to do is don't try to put your finger and try to remove it. If you are able to see the coin in the mouth and if it is visible and you can safely remove it, then you should try. Don't put your fingers in the mouth and make the child vomit. That can cause a serious problem. Don't give anything from the mouth, including water, till you reach the hospital and get it checked by the doctor. Most of the coin ingestion are generally less harmful, but if child is feeling severe throat pain, child is not able to swallow, then yes, you have to rush to the hospital immediately. Let's take the another object, which is battery. Battery is quite harmful. If you have noticed the child has swallowed the battery, then it is a real emergency. You have to reach to the hospital immediately. Before reaching the hospital, what you can do at home is give the baby around 1 to 2 spoon of the honey. There are some evidences which are saying that honey is little bit useful when the child has ingested a battery. So once you have given 1 or 2 spoon of honey, then don't give anything. Keep the child without anything. Don't give water, don't give juice, nothing you will give. And don't put your finger in the throat and try to make the child vomit. Don't do all these things. Suppose if your child has ingested a magnet. If it is a magnet, if it is a single magnet, then it is not a very emergency. But if child has taken a multiple magnets, like small metal balls child has ingested, then yes, it can cause a real emergency. You have to rush to the hospital immediately to take the doctor's opinion. Once you reach to the hospital, what the doctor will do? Doctor will first try to assess the baby's condition, how is baby's airway, how is the baby's breathing. Then maybe he will advise certain x-rays to look out that where the foreign body, where the coin is placed, where the magnet which child has ingested, where is it, whether it is in the stomach, whether it is in the intestine, whether it is still in the food pipe. So doctor will take one x-ray to check all these things out. 80 to 90% of the time, if it is a coin ingestion, then generally no treatment required. So they will keep on following it up, and maybe they will take 2 or 3 x-rays serially to check it out till the coin passed out into the stool. Suppose if the foreign body is a battery and if it is still in the food pipe, then the doctor will do the endoscopy. What is the endoscopy? Endoscopy is one kind of the device where at one end there is a camera. It will get inserted through the mouth and it will go to the food pipe. It will take up that battery and they will pull it out. Those kind of the surgeries might require. Most of the time, foreign bodies like the coin are not much serious. But some of the foreign bodies, like the sharp objects, like the pin, safety pin, hair band, yes, that will be tackled on the emergency basis. If the foreign body is larger, more than 5 cm of the size foreign body, it definitely requires to be the removal by the surgery. So commonest harmful foreign bodies are batteries, magnets, sharp objects, and the objects which is bigger than 5 cm. Those objects you have to take it very seriously and rush to the hospital immediately. I hope this video must be useful to you. If you like this video, press the like button, share with your friends so that they also know that how to tackle this type of the situation at home. And if you are first time on my YouTube channel, subscribe as well and keep the notification on so that you will get all the updates from my videos. Thank you very much.